Good evening.
Hi, teacher.
Hi, hello, Novia. Good evening.
How are you?
Good, and you?
Good, too.
Ah, really? How was your day?
Fine.
Fine? No, great. I'm glad to hear that. That's great.
Yes.
Hi, good evening, Diana.
Good evening, teacher.
How was your day, Diana?
Bored.
Bored? Why?
Tuve que contar todo el día tu inventario.
Really?
Yes, really.
That's a lot of things. That must be like kind of boring, as you said. But anyways, the good thing is that the day has ended up and we just like finish this class and then you might rest and you can rest. That's the good thing. Okay, so who's coming? Ah, Eric is here. Hi, Eric.
Hi, how are you?
Good.
Hi.
You? Hi.
So relaxed.
Relaxed? Yeah, you look like kind of relaxed. Yeah.
De todo modo, ¿qué vamos a hacer?
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
Pasé en reunión de 8:30 de la mañana a 1:30 de la tarde.
Niño, pero va a descansar la próxima semana.
Ajá.
Ah, qué galán. ¿Sabe que voy a estar en una sucursal aquí en Caballería, Carretera Santa Ana? Voy a estar lunes, martes y miércoles hasta mediodía. Voy a trabajar hasta mediodía. Y luego, esa es en las sucursales, en las ferreterías. Y en los puntos de venta, voy a estar hasta... Ahí sí me toca de turno por cualquier cosa.
Oh my God. So it's going to be a hard week. Yeah, it's going to be a hard week. But, I mean.
Eso es lo malo de ser importante uno en el negocio.
Yeah, like to be part of the team leader. But it's good, man. It's good. Yeah.
Pero ahí vamos. Ahí vamos.
Yeah, there we go.
Lo importante es no rendirse a pesar de las cosas que pasen y buscar después las oportunidades para irse a dar un relax.
¿Se da cuenta, teacher? Bien humildemente, como él se hace a sentir, ¿verdad?
Yeah, right. Like we're very humble. Yeah, that's being humble. Yeah, I don't know. That's cool. That's good, Eddie. Okay. Let me see. Who else is in here? Good evening, Ever. How are you today?
Good evening, teacher.
How are you, mister?
Yeah. I'm fine. Everything okay.
Everything okay?
Yeah.
That's great.
Thank you.
That's great. How was your day?
A little stressful, but for the traffic, terrible, horrible for the whole day.
The whole day. Getting stuck in traffic. The traffic in San Salvador is like horrible, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you have to spend a lot of time in traffic to get to your house and to get to your job. Hopefully, here in Oriente, we don't have that problem. The traffic is kind of fluid in here. Even though we're waiting on traffic, we're like, oh man, I'm gonna get late. But we stayed like, 15 minutes on traffic? But in San Salvador, it's like hours, right? In some places. Especially when there are accidents.
They're crazy for the whole day.
The whole day. Now in here, it's mostly... Yeah. In here, it's mostly in the morning, especially at 6 and 7, and from 3 in the afternoon, from 3 to 5. Those are like the hours in which the traffic jam is like horrible in here. But then during the day, I mean, everything is like good. You can, I mean, you're not going to be like stuck in traffic.
Good.
Yeah, that's a good thing.
Sí, con el calor que hace, ¿quién va a querer salir ahí en el lapso del día, teacher?
No, actually, but people can do it, like, in here. No, es cierto, like el calor ha estado horrible acá. Just imagine there. Imagínense que ustedes en San Salvador están diciendo que hay calor. Ajá, ahora acá en San Miguel. Horrible.
Se derriten las...
Exactly. No hay necesidad de ir al gym acá para derretirla.
Para sacar
la grasa corporal. Exactly. Nah, but we get accustomed to that. Eric, menos mal se salvó, no, porque ya estaba casi llorando que venía para San Miguel, right, Eric?
Right, teacher. Save by the bell, como decían antes. Salvado por la campana.
Exactly. Okay. All right, people. So we're going to start a little bit with the things that we got for today. Ahora vamos a tener un tema bastante interesante. Vamos a comenzar a ver un poco sobre el uso de los ing en los verbos después de ciertas preposiciones. Vamos a comenzar con la lista de asistencia. Estaba esperando a los demás, pero I don't know what happened. But let's start with the attendance list, and then we're going to focus on the main topic that we have for tonight. Okay, let's see. Ana Claribel, is it here? No. Okay. Ana María, neither Ana María. Diana Gabriela. No, okay, got it there. Eric Guillermo.
Present, teacher.
Okay, good. Ever de Jesús.
Present.
Perfect. Fátima Alejandra. No hear you. Floridalia. Nah, she hasn't showed up yet. Hilmar Cruz. Hey, Hilmar is not here yet. Okay. Jonathan Alexander. Not here. Carla Benacer.
Present, teacher.
Ah, okay. Natalie Vanessa. Okay. She usually comes late. Nubia Zulema.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Romeo Alexis. Okay. Rosa del Carmen. Rosa, are you there?
Present.
Ah, okay. Are you sleeping, Rosa? No, not yet. Ah, okay, not yet. Roxana Yesenia, okay, not here. Salvador Alfonso, hey, what happened to Salvador? He usually comes early. No se ha conectado.
No, creo que no se va a conectar ahora, teacher.
Ah.
Teacher, es fin de mes. Día viernes y el cuerpo lo sabe.
Yes. Ahorita de estar bien happy.
A no ver por qué no la dejaron salir.
Ok. Sara Carolina. Not here yet. Ok. Stephanie Lissette. She's not here. William Alberto. No here. Joanny.
Listen.
Nah, ok. Perfect. And Stephanie Janet, which is. She hasn't come yet. Okay, she hasn't connected yet.
Good evening.
Ah, good evening, Gilmar. Ah, you're here already. Okay, I'm a set you up in here in the attendance list. And Fatima, if I'm not wrong. Ah, yeah, Fatima's here. Okay. Let's see. Floor. Fatima, what is it? Okay, good. In order to start with the things that we got for today, I'm going to share these things. Ahora nos vamos a enfocar un poco más en el manual, okay? We're going to work the most in the manual. In here, I just bring up something a little bit like brief and presentation. I'm just going to show you the topic that we're gonna have during this section, which is this one. Can you see the presentation? Can you see a presentation, people?
Yes, teacher.
All right, perfect. So this is the video conference number 2. And today's topic is going to be how to use ing forms after prepositions. Okay. Ahora vamos a ver un conjunto de expresiones que necesitamos ciertas preposiciones, okay, para formarlas, y que luego de estas preposiciones necesitamos un verbo en ing. Okay, that's what we are going to be discussing today. This is pretty much what we have. But before continuing with this, we're gonna have, let's see, shoulder in here. Just like the agenda, okay? Like the general things that we got for today. The first thing that we're gonna be doing today is, as everybody knows, let's start with a review from the previous class. Vamos a comenzar un poco con un repaso de la clase. ¿Qué fue lo que estuvimos viendo la clase pasada? Okay, let's start a little bit with that. And then we're going to start with the uses of the ing verbs or ing forms after some prepositions. En este caso nos vamos a enfocar más, por así decirlo, en el uso de ciertas expresiones. Okay, just to create examples related to our jobs. After that, we're gonna have a conversation practice related to the topic, of course, which is in the manual. If I'm not wrong, it's gonna be in page 14 in your manuals. And after the conversation practice, we're gonna have to solve some exercises, okay? We're gonna work basically on the manual. After that, we're gonna complete some exercises that are in there. Exercises from yesterday's class and some exercises from today's class. Remember that we are going to have just this class. Next week, we're on vacation. Hey, that's cool. We're gonna have vacation. Okay. But you, I mean, in my case, I'm not gonna have vacation. Meh. I'm like complaining like Eric. But anyways, such is life. Okay, the first thing that we're gonna be doing by like right now is to have a short feedback from yesterday's class. So what we were discussing yesterday, people, can somebody tell me what was the topic from yesterday? Any volunteer?
Question to start. Infinitive.
Uh-huh, we were discussing some questions. Okay. Thank you, Carla. Ever, tell me.
No, the same. They hope to use the infinitives.
Ah, how to use the infinitives. Okay, very good. That's one of them. That was like the main topic. Okay, very good. How to use infinitives, people? How do we use infinitives? Or when do we use infinitives?
The verb.
Nah, okay, that's the formula. So basically we add 2 to the main verb, right? So if I've got the verb eat, I can say in infinitive is to eat.
To eat.
To eat. Ah, perfect. Very good. Somebody else? Diana, what do you remember from yesterday's class?
The mission. Sobre la, conversación que estuvimos practicando.
Ah, okay.
El verbo en infinitivo.
Ah, yeah, people. Do you do the discussion in the platform? Fatima, you did it, right? I saw your expression, Fatima. Así como cuando el teacher en la escuela le preguntaba, ¿trajo la tarea? No, no la traje. That was your expression, Fátima. Esta sola se quemó. Aprenda, Hilmar. Hilmar, you did it, right?
Sí, la tarea se la comió el chucho.
La computadora. The computer. Uh-huh. Okay. All right. But now tell me, do you know the mission of your company, Fatima, in your case? Eric, come on, Eric. Are you serious? You don't know it? Okay.
I don't know.
Jesus Christ. Okay.
Sorry. <All right.
laughs> Fatima, what is the mission of your company?
No sé, teacher, cómo decir en inglés, cómo colocar los mejores productos en el mercado.
To place
the products into the market. The best product into market supermarket.
No, in the market. Market means in general. Okay, uh-huh. That's general. Because supermarket is where you go to buy things.
Okay, thank you.
Ah, okay. Good. Ajá.
Yo tengo la empresa.
Ajá, ajá. Which one is it?
To communicate, mm-hmm. to grow, encourage, participation of in cultural sport informational space and entertainment with total democrat freedom and looks strengthen or identity.
Okay, good. That's the one. Okay, Hilmar, thank you. Huh. Ever, do you know the mission of your company, Ever?
Yeah, no. Our mission is to provide our customer with excellent quality product for engine resurfacer or grinding workshops.
Mm-hmm. Okay, very good. Nubia, how about you? Just like thinking what to say.
I don't remember, but another time I write in the homework.
Okay, Nubia, okay. So let's see, I know Jonathan is not gonna, it's going to be like kind of responsible. Jonathan, what is the mission of your company?
I don't understand the question.
Did you remember that yesterday we were discussing infinitives by using two?
Not much.
A little bit? Jonathan, were you busy yesterday?
Sí.
Yeah, right. You told me that you were not participating in class because you were busy, right?
I practiced dialogue.
You practice the dialogue. Yeah, that's true. Okay. Do you know the mission of your company, Jonathan?
Mission or vision?
The mission. That's a lot, the first thing that we were discussing. The mission. What is it?
My mission is.
All right. Tell me.
We show the world standard.
You know it or you don't know it? Okay, entonces no se sabe la misión de la empresa. Okay. Let's see, William, how about you? What is the mission of your company? I know William knows it.
Okay. To be the best company, product and service in the country.
Nah, okay. Very good. In the country. Product services in the country. Okay. Thank you, William. Rosa, how about you? Yeah, turn on your camera, people. I want to see. Rosa, what's the mission of your company?
Es que usted me va a hacer leña porque no me la sé.
¿Y por qué la voy a hacer leña?
Es que me va a agarrar de base, ya sé.
Oh my God. I mean, you're not the only one. Like, Nubia doesn't know it. Fatima neither. Well, Eric doesn't know it. You see? Okay. Good. But I know Diana knows it. Right, Diana? What's the mission of your company, Diana? Diana?
The mission is
service
customer and sell.
Service customer and sell.
En eso prácticamente se basa todo, servicio al cliente y vender.
Okay, customer service and then sales. Okay. Yeah, we can put it like that way. To be like. Okay. Thank you, Diana. Natalie, now you're coming. What's the mission of your company? She doesn't remember either.
My mission is service, mensajería, no sé cómo se dice.
Okay, what do you mean? But what is the focus of your company, Natalie? What is the focus of your company?
¿Cuál es el qué?
What's the focus of your company? Mensajería.
Mensajería. Sí, envío de mensajería.
Yeah, because that would be like messenger. That would be like messenger service, like mensajería. But
messenger service. Messenger service.
Okay. All right. Put it away. Let's see if Mrs. Urrutia says something different. welcome, by the way. Good. Look, she looks angry. Mrs. Urrutia, are you there?
Yes, teacher.
What's she doing? She looks like stressed. Why do you look like kind of a stress, Mrs. Rusia? Hello.
Hello.
Mrs. Stephanie, do you know the mission of your company? Yo sé que usted sí se lo sabe. Natalie no se lo sabe, pero yo sé que usted sí.
¿Cómo? No le entendí. Me dijo.
What is the mission of your company?
¿Cuál es?
Oh my God. Are you serious?
Yes.
Hey, what happened to my screen? It looks weird. Okay, give me a second. No sé por qué me está fallando. mi camarita.
Teacher se queda como congelado.
Yeah, that's true. Give me a second. I'm gonna check what is that. I'm gonna check. Give me a second.
Van a salir unos buenos stickers ahora, teacher.
Hey, no sé. Sí. Why? Hey, I don't know what happened to this. Give me a second. I think I have problems because the thing is that I bought a new camera today. And apparently I'm having some issues with it. And I don't know why. Give me a second. HP. I'm gonna turn it into the next one. Hey, that's weird. I don't know why. Ah, yeah, I have it now. I think it must be for the internet thing. Okay, what are we gonna do like right now with those things? Listen, as I told you, what we are going to do is we are going to focus the most on the uses of ing verbs after some prepositions. Y lo que vamos a estar trabajando ahora es, digamos, una estructura, ¿ok? En la cual vamos a utilizar los verbos en ing después de ciertas preposiciones. And to make it this like a little bit easier for you, we are going just to start working with a couple of phrases. Vamos a comenzar con un par de frases. Okay, these phrases, after these phrases, we generally use, okay, the ing form. Okay, it says ing after prepositions. Let's start up with these things. And then we're gonna move on to the manual because the main work is going to be done in the manual. Okay, look at this. It says, use a verb plus ing after prepositions like for or of. Básicamente, ahora nos vamos a enfocar un poco más en estas dos preposiciones. Son for and of. To create examples. In expressions as. Y es, acá están algunas de las expresiones que les mencionaba con las cuales vamos a estar trabajando. We got be responsible for. Be responsible for. Be in charge of. Listen up. Be in charge of. Be accountable for. Okay. Be accountable for. The next one is committed to. Okay, and dedicated to. So those ones are like the most common phrases that we are going to be focusing this class. Okay, there are more, of course, but we're gonna focus us the most in these expressions. Okay, to create example sentences based on what we do in our job, okay? And later on, we're gonna start by doing some exercises and some examples with this. Okay, let's write down some examples. Natalie, help me out reading this one.
I am responsible. No, no sé cómo se pronuncia eso, teacher.
Responsible.
Responsible for sending emails for the clients. And to my clients.
To my clients. Okay. Si podemos observar ahí, después de responsible for, después de la preposición for, el siguiente verbo que vamos a colocar, sea cual sea el verbo, tiene que ir en ing. En este caso, el verbo que tenemos ahí en ing es el verbo send, ¿ok? which is like together with the ing form is sending emails to my clients. How do you interpret this example, people? How do you interpret this sentence? Do you know what it means? Ever? For example, ever, do you know what it is?
I think the translate for this.
Yeah, yeah. How do you interpret that one?
Yo soy responsable de los envíos. Yo soy responsable de los envíos de los correos a mis clientes. O soy responsable de los envíos del correo de mis clientes.
Ah, okay. O de enviar, right? Soy responsable de enviar correos a mis clientes. Very good, Ever. Thank you. Yeah, basically in here, if you see, besides, okay, using or despite of using ing, it doesn't mean that the example is in present continuous. You're not talking here about present continuous, okay? The structure is mostly in simple present. A pesar que tenemos el ing en el verbo, no significa que estemos usando presente continuo, acción en el instante, ¿ok? Don't get confused on that. Recuerden que ya les había mencionado anteriormente que después de ciertas palabras, ciertas preposiciones, cuando escribimos un verbo, generalmente siempre tenemos que colocarlo en ing, ¿ok? It's by a rule that we have to do that, ¿ok? And this is a clear example of that. We got another one. Okay, Nubia, help me a reading, please.
Okay, teacher. She is in charge of training the new employees.
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 Okay, she is in charge of training the new employees. Okay, so in that case, we got another phrase. Okay, in charge of. Okay, so how do you understand this example? What is in charge of? Can somebody tell me how do you understand in charge of?
Encargado de.
Exactly, encargado de. Okay, so in this case, it says she's in charge of training the new employees, right? Like ella es encargada de entrenar los nuevos, okay, empleados, or like workers, as you might call them. Very good. Next example. It says, Hilmer, help me out, please.
He is accountable for hiring new employees.
Ah, okay, very good. And what do you understand by accountable for, Hilmer?
I don't know.
Huh? Accountable for. What is accountable for you or for everybody? What is accountable? How do you understand by accountable? That would be the word. It doesn't have anything to do with accountant. No tiene nada que ver con cosas contables.
Así como de explicar.
¿Ah?
Como de explicar.
Como contable, teacher.
¿Ah? ¿No?
Es como responsable de.
Exactly. Accountable for means to be responsible for. Esta palabra viene siendo, o esta frase viene siendo sinónimo de responsible for. Okay? Accountable for. It's likely similar for responsible for. ¿Ok? Entonces, en este caso, vienen siendo palabras sinónimas o frases sinónimas. Responsible for and accountable for. That's why it says, he is accountable for hiring new employees. So, what it means? Ah,
él es contratar nuevos empleados.
Exactly. Él es el responsable de contratar, ¿ok? Nuevos empleados. That's what it is. Okay, in your company, what are you accountable for? In this case, Ever, What are you accountable for in your company?
In my case?
Yes.
I am accountable for to sell the new products or all to the all my customer and try to to open the new market.
The new market. Ah, okay.
That's right.
Very good. But in this case, Ever, remember, I am accountable for selling. If I'm not going
selling.
To sell, right? Aha. Remember that after four, we have to use the verb in ing, selling. Okay.
Okay. Perfect.
Thank you. Eric, in your case, what are you accountable for in your company?
I accountable for the system of point of sales of the stores.
In that case, it will be I am accountable for managing the system. All right?
Managing
is like encargado de manejar el sistema, right? Okay.
Right.
Very good. Nice. Nubia, how about you? What are you accountable for in your company?
The customer service. How do you say el encargado de administración?
In charge of the administration. So you're an administrator in there?
No, my boss.
So you are like la que le sigue al administrador? What?
Contador.
An accountant? That's what, that's your position in there?
Customer service.
You're in customer service.
Mm-hmm.
So you are in charge of customer service.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right. Alejandra, how about you? What are you accustomed or in charge of in that case? What are you accountable for in your company?
¿Te estás refiriendo a mí, teacher?
Obviously, you're Alejandra.
No, yo no sé si hay otra Alejandra en la clase, teacher.
No, there's any other one.
Es que nadie casi me dice así. Por eso, nadie usa mi segundo nombre, sí.
Okay.
I am is accountable.
I am accountable
for financial reports, for reportes financieros.
In that case, it's like for doing the financial records.
Okay. I am is accountable for doing financial reports.
Okay. Good. So you got a good position there. Very good. William, how about you, mister? What are you accountable for in your company?
Okay. In my company, I accountable for service customer.
Service customer.
Yeah.
Are you a representative?
In the first line, in the line first, yes.
Okay. There you go. Thank you, mister.
Okay.
Rosa, how about you? Hey, why you people have the cameras off? Turn them on. It's like, okay, good. Rosa, I thought you were sleeping. Okay, what are you accountable for in your company?
I am
I am comfortable for how do you say cobrar?
What do you mean by that? Church?
How do you...
Church? Church? But in what way?
Church. Okay. I am accountable for a church.
Uh-huh. Church.
The customer. The customer.
Ah, okay. Good. Este se encarga de ir al de. Okay.
De desembolsarla ahí.
Yes, la parte que no nos gusta, right? Yes. Okay. So in that case, how would you say? I am accountable for charging. Okay, in that case, charging the monthly fee to the customers. That would be your position.
Okay.
No? All right. Let's see who else. Carla, how about you?
Okay, teacher. I am comfortable the export correctly the containers to other country.
Okay. But in that case, it would be I am accountable for exporting, because export, that's the verb, okay? Exporting.
Okay.
Say it again, Carla.
I am accountable for export correctly the
exporting,
container.
Exporting.
Exporting correctly,
uh-huh,
the container to other country.
To other countries. Ah, okay. Very good. There you go, Carla. Thank you. Jonathan? Okay.
I am accountable for reception of motorcycle. After call, the client.
Nah, okay, all right. Hilmer, thank you, mister.
I am accountable for computer network.
Accountable for computer network.
See, computer network.
But in that case, you're developing something in there, Hilmer?
What?
Are you developing something in there?
No,
in that case, I mean, are you like performing? Are you like doing or creating something?
No sé a qué se refiere.
Okay, en este caso, usted crea contenidos, crea algo.
No, es la red informática, computer network.
Ah, okay. So in that case,
manager.
You manage that.
Manager. Okay, manager the internet.
Okay. So in that case, you might say, I am accountable for managing the computer network.
Okay.
Yeah, because you're the one in charge of like checking everything related to computers, right?
Okay.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Okay, very good. Thank you, Hilmar. Hey, are you serious? Ana Maria is connecting late. I thought you were not connecting. Okay. Yeah.
Tenía un problema en un documento que estoy tratando de activar con mi oficina y no puedo.
Excuses. Right, Ana Maria? You say yes.
No, le comentaba que tengo un problema en oficina con un documento y no lo puedo enviar, así que por eso me entre tarde.
Okay. I thought you were sleeping. Okay, good. Sara, welcome, Sara. Listen,
hi, teacher.
We're on this thing on this kind of phrases, and we were discussing the phrase "be accountable for." That means like ser responsable de. Okay, in this case, applying to your job, Sara, what are you accountable for in your company?
Okay, teacher, acabo de entrar, pero creo que más o menos, ¿verdad? Intentaré. I am responsible for selling liquors to the canteen, supermercados, restaurantes.
Supermarkets and restaurants. Okay, all right. And we were saying that basically responsible for and accountable for viene siendo lo mismo. Entonces usted también puede decir I am accountable for y luego lo que dijo, okay?
Okay.
Okay, good. Who else has not participated? Joanny? Are you there, Joanny? Joanny? Hello.
Hola, teacher. Me oye.
Yes, yes. Did you have problems with the internet?
Sí, me saca bien seguido de la plataforma, no sé qué pasa.
Probably it's the internet.
Puede ser que sí.
Okay. All right, now, Johnny, what are you accountable for in your company?
I content for producer quality food.
Mm-hmm. Okay. That's your main food in there. Okay, good. Thank you, Giovanni. Yes. Mrs. Urrutia?
Yes, teacher.
What are you accountable for in your company?
I'm accountable for the liquidate of correspondence and setting the report for the client.
For sending reports. Nah? Okay. Thank you, Mrs. Okay, let's see who's gonna be like the last.
Welcome, teacher.
Yeah. Okay, good. Let's see, Diana, are you there? You're 16 out of 21. Five are missing. Diana, are you there?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, tell me, what are you accountable for in your company?
I am accountable for the take the inventory. I am accountable the assist for the assist customer.
Okay, for assisting customer.
Yes. Not for assist customer.
Okay, assisting customers. Okay. That's kind of difficult job, right? Like to assist customers, especially when customers are like angry. That must be kind of stressing. Yes. Rosa del Carmen must know about that. Ella debe saber más de ello. Right, Rosa? Yeah, es la encargada.
Hi.
Es la encargada de decir, hey, págueme.
¿Qué pasó?
Okay, no, forget about it, Rosa. You must be sleeping. Okay, good. Let's continue with this. Right after this short expressions, we're gonna see the other ones on context in the manual. Okay, let's continue. Next example. Listen, he is dedicated to his job. In this case, when we use to, it's mostly, right, like dedicado a, dedicated to. In that case, it refers to like dedicado hacia alguien, okay, to something. In that case, I think most of you are dedicated to your family, okay, especially talking about something personal. Most of you are dedicated to do a good job in your company. if I'm not grand. In your case, Eric, what are you dedicated to? What are you dedicated?
The number one to my family.
Okay, I am dedicated to my family.
And number two to my work.
Mm-hmm.
And number three to me.
To myself.
To myself.
Okay. Yeah, that might be. I think I need to do those rules too, those setups, because I don't dedicate time to myself. Nah. And I think I'm doing it wrong. Mm-hmm. Fatima, in your case, what are you dedicated to?
I am dedicated to self. And second is dedicated to my family. My professional teacher.
To your husband?
No. My mother,
Okay, to your mother.
Mother, my sister, grandmother.
Okay, very good. There you go. Thank you, Fatima. Let's see, Ana Maria, listen up. Who are you dedicated to?
No le entendí, teacher. ¿A quién me dedico yo? ¿Qué es lo que dedico?
To whom you dedicate?
Mm-hmm.
You dedicate. Okay. Uh-huh.
And first,
I am.
And number one is my family. It's my daughter. It's my mother. Number one.
Uh-huh.
Number two is my work.
Okay.
Number three is the so-so my class is English.
Good. Now I am focusing on who is going to repeat module number three.
So-so.
Okay, good, Maria. Thank you. All right, let's see, Jonathan, who are you dedicated to as main dedication?
I am dedicated to my baby.
Okay, good.
Yeah, my family, my work.
Okay, good, Jonathan. All right, Mr. William, who are you dedicated to?
I am dedicated my job.
So your job? Uh-huh.
And my house. And my family.
And your family. Okay. That's pretty cool. Those are like the three main aspects in life that we are dedicated to, right? Okay, Mr. William, thank you.
Okay.
All right, William. Hilmar. Thank you, William. Hilmar, who are you dedicated to?
I dedicate my family to my profession and my hobbies.
And your hobbies. What are your hobbies, mister?
I play chess and play video games.
Really? I don't know how to play chess. I was learning how to play chess, and for real, I got frustrated. I couldn't play. I don't know why. I mean, it's so difficult for me to play chess. I don't know. I sometimes do like ground movements. Yeah,
I have a closed chest.
Ah, yeah, I mean like los peones tienen que avanzar tanto, the queen, another one, the king, another one. I was like, I got bored. Yeah, but that's a mental game. That's pretty cool. No, that's why I got a Rubik's Cube. Eso sí no me aburre. Like when I'm like stressed or bored, I used to play with the Rubik's Cube. I don't know how to solve it yet, but I do it. Aunque a veces me frustra porque no lo puedo hacer, pero it's a game. Yeah. Okay, good. Me dice Surrutia, don't fall asleep. Tell me, who are you dedicated to?
I am dedicated to my children and myself.
And yourself?
Yeah.
That's it? Ah,
okay. That's it.
Nice. Okay. There you go. Thank you. Ever, did I ask you? Not right. I don't remember. Okay. Who are you dedicated to?
In the first place, I am dedicated to my family, my work. Mm-hmm. And right now, I try to dedicate it to the English class too.
Ah, okay, very good. And you're doing it good. Yeah, because you're improving a lot since you started. Okay, good. Diana, how about you? Who are you dedicated to, Diana?
No le escucho.
Ah, okay. Who are you dedicated to? Do you listen to me? Ah, de casualidad no tiene bajo el volumen, Diana. Sí, porque inclusive su audio casi no se escucha. No sé si los demás logran escucharle. No, right.
Entonces quizás es mi dispositivo.
Ahí está, ahora sí se le escucha un poco más fuerte. Yeah, probably it's the device. We were discussing about the things or the aspects in which we are dedicated to. Now I was asking you, who are you dedicated to? Because most of your classmates are dedicated to their family, to their jobs, to their kids, to sleep, like all the people that I'm watching right now. But I'm gonna mention name. This is Rutian. Okay. But I think you have problems, Diana, with the,
you,
the device. You're welcome. You know. Okay. Ya sabe. Okay. Who else? Romeo. I had never asked Romeo. My God, Romeo ya rato se está queriendo participar. Romeo, who are you dedicated to?
Dedicated family.
Mm-hmm.
Dedicated joke. And dedicated story.
Ah, are you studying, Romeo?
Sorry.
Really? What career are you studying?
No.
Ah, what career?
Llevo ingeniería mecatrónica.
Which one?
Ingeniería.
Ingeniería en electrónica.
Sí. No, mecatrónica.
Mecatrónica.
Sí.
What is that about, Romeo? Mecatrónica. What is that? I had never heard about that.
Yo creo que eso casi no hay en diferentes universidades, por eso.
Ah, pero ¿de qué trata?
va orientado más que todo a automatización y área industrial también.
Ah, cool. Mm-hmm. That's really cool, man. Okay, good luck with that, man. Good. Okay, let's continue with this. Listen, actually, you have this on your manuals if you want to check them. It says, to say who you report to, use be responsible to and be accountable to. So, básicamente, para decir en este caso, a quién reportamos algo, okay, vamos a usar be responsible to and be accountable to. In this case, those two, okay, what is like the main point of those type of expressions? Listen, when we say or when we mention in a sentence, be responsible to and be accountable to, it's like ser responsable ante alguien, okay? In this case, it might be to your customers, it might be to your family, it might be to your, to your house, to your customers, okay? Dependiendo del área donde trabajemos, okay? O de quién o de qué ambiente nos estemos manejando, así pues va a ser el tipo de responsabilidades que probablemente vayamos a tener, okay? So, keep that on mind. Give me a second. What happened to my camera? That be responsible to and be accountable to, it means, okay, like ser responsable ante alguien, okay? That's what it is. Like ser responsable ante alguien, okay? In this case, I think I got some examples. In a second. Yeah, I got some example in here. Ana Garcia, help me on reading the example, please.
Me acabo de conectar, teacher, no sé de qué están hablando.
No. Just read the example. Solo léame el ejemplo. I think you got your microphone off.
I am responsibly.
Responsible.
Responsible to my clients.
Clients
in my job.
Ah, okay, very good. I am responsible to my clients in my job. Okay, so what it means, soy responsable, okay, de mis clientes o ante mis clientes en mi trabajo. So in your case, let's see, okay, Natalie. Okay, in your case, who are you responsible to?
In mi trabajo.
Yes.
I am responsible to inventory.
But in this case, it will be like referring to people, mostly to people. Who do you work with? Do you work with clients? ¿Ante quién usted tiene que ser, like, how to say this, like, responsable?
Ante mi jefe.
Ah, okay. So, how's your expression? I am
responsible to my boss, creo que se dice, ¿verdad?
Yes, to my boss.
Okay.
To my boss. I think most of you are responsible to your bosses, okay? All right, let's continue. Look at this. She is accountable to her boss. Why accountable? ¿Qué decíamos que era accountable to? Be accountable to?
Responsable.
Exactly, okay? Entonces, esas dos frases son sinónimas, ¿ok? Ambas tienen el mismo significado, ¿ok? Both of them got the same meaning. Be responsible to and be accountable to are basically synonyms. When to use them? In this case, accountable to tend to be more formal than responsible to, okay? Es un tanto menos común, más que todo en el inglés hablado, es más usada responsible to que accountable to. So, pero en situaciones un tanto más formales, digamos que es un tanto más usada el accountable to, okay? Better than responsible to. That's the way how to use them. But they are synonyms.
Responsabilidad.
Yes, son lo mismo. Significan, son sinónimos. Son frases sinónimas. Yeah. Ser responsables ante. Okay. Acá es ante una persona. Remember that. Que cuando llevamos to, es cuando después del to vamos a colocar una persona, un jefe o alguien adicional. Okay. O cuando nos referimos a la familia. Okay. In this case, cuando llevamos to, cuando llevamos for, es responsable, pero de actividades que usted tiene que hacer. Y cuando llevamos for, generalmente ahí es cuando colocamos el ing al verbo. ¿Ok? Tenemos, recuerden esto, tenemos be responsible to y be responsible for. ¿Ok? ¿Qué es lo único que cambia? What we change? La preposición, the preposition, to and for. To es más usado, ok, cuando tenemos que rendir cuentas a una persona. O decir, ah, soy responsable ante alguien, ante mis clientes, mi jefe, ok, mi familia, ok, mi esposa, mi esposo, mis hijos, whatever, ok, but related to people. ¿Ok? Ante alguien, cuando usamos to. Cuando usamos for, es cuando usted es responsable de hacer su trabajo o de hacer actividades adicionales. Pueden o no ser de su trabajo. ¿Ok? Example, listen up. I am responsible for teaching English every night. Ah, soy responsable de enseñar inglés todas las noches. ¿Estoy ahí refiriéndome a otra persona? ¿O rindiendo cuentas a otra persona? No, right? ¿En qué estoy ahí hablando? I'm talking about what I am doing, about my job, ¿ok? Acerca de una actividad que yo tengo que hacer, an activity that I have to do, ¿ok? So, keep that in mind. Two is when we talk about an extra person, okay? And four is when we talk about the activities that we do. So keep that in mind. Okay, hasta ahora, ¿tenemos alguna pregunta? Any question related to this?
No sé si estoy equivocado o no sé si entendí.
Okay, tell me.
Responsible to es como para personas.
Yes, ser responsable ante alguien, ante su compañía, ante su jefe, sus clientes.
Y responsible for es cuando cosas, por ejemplo, cosas que hago.
Exactly, las actividades que usted hace. Ya, yeah. Ser responsable de, en su caso, manejar, managing, the computer system from your company, for example. Right? Oh. That is something that you have to do, okay? It's part of your job. Pero ahí ya no estamos involucrando a ninguna otra persona, okay? Yeah. Okay. That's what it is. Any other question?
No? Teacher, le toca pasar en lista.
Exactly. Eso simplemente, bueno, en eso estaba preguntando porque ya son las 9:08. It's time to do the second
attempt. Está bien esa presión, Nubia.
Nubia is responsible to remember this teacher.
No. Nubia is dedicated.
For remembering. Okay, for remembering. Okay, good.
For remembering.
Yes. Voy a dejar de compartir por un momento mientras paso asistencia. Give me a second. I don't know why it keeps me frozen this thing out. This thing out. Okay, let's start up. Give me a second. Ana Claribel.
Present.
Ah, okay, good. Ana Maria.
Present.
Ah, okay, good. Diana Gabriela.
Present.
Okay, ¿puedo solventar el problema, Diana?
Sí, ya lo escucho mejor, teacher.
Ah, perfect. Eric Guillermo.
Present, teacher.
Perfect. Ever de Jesús.
Present, teacher.
Okay, excellent. Fatima Alejandra.
Present.
Okay. Flor Idalia. I think she's not connected. Hilmar Cruz.
Present.
All right, great. Jonathan Alexander.
Present.
Okay, Carla Benacer.
Present, teacher.
Okay, Natalie Vanessa.
Present.
Oh my God, perdiendo flow, Natalie.
Edito.
Yes. Nubia Zulema.
Present, teacher.
Ah, okay, great. Hey, what happened? Romeo Alexis.
Present.
Perfect, Romeo. Rosa del Carmen.
Present.
Where is Rosa? Ah, okay. Good. Roxana Yesenia is not here. Salvador Alfonso is not here. Sara Carolina.
Present. Present, teacher.
Okay. Stephanie Lisette. Stephanie Lisette, ya le puse una asistencia.
Present, present, ah. Present, present.
Ah, okay, good. William Alberto.
Present.
Ah, okay, good. Joanny Noemi. Hey, where is Joanny? Ah, there you go. Joanny, do you still show problems?
Sí, teacher, siempre me saca, no sé por qué.
Yeah.
A decir.
Okay, good. And Stephanie Janet. Hey, Stephanie Janet didn't show up today. Okay, let's continue with this. Give me a second. I'm going to share the presentation that we are having in here.
Teacher.
Yes.
¿Puede hacer como en el módulo anterior, mandarnos la diapositiva?
Okay, if you want, give me a second. Actually, what I was telling to your classmates is that since I don't have that much information in the presentation, because today we're going to focus the most on the manual. So right after these examples, we are going to move on to the manuals, but I'm going to share the presentation. Give me a second. It is loading. Like WhatsApp thing is loading. Oh my God, I don't have the phone off. Ah, there you go. Okay, let's see, what is it? Let's see. Oh my God, cuánto mensaje. What is this? Give me a second. I am just loading this thing. Document. Presentation. This is number two. Done it. There you go. Okay, so you have it there. Yeah, there you go. Ahí lo tienen. Okay, so let's continue with this. So we had it here. So remember, when we use to is when we mention an extra person, like a boss, like part of a family, okay, customers, or any other person. When we use for, is basically when we mention the activities that we have to do, okay? Just keep that in mind. Let's continue with this. Huh. Now, what are we going to have in here? Bien, ahora quiero que se vayan a su manual, okay? Open up the page 14 in your manual, and you will find out this conversation, okay? For this conversation, listen up. No nos vamos a ir a practicar esta conversación como lo hicimos ayer. What are we going to do with this? Lo vamos a hacer acá, okay? In the main section. Right after I finish with the reading part, let's do, if you have any problem with a vocabulary, just let me know. We solve that issue, and then we are going to practice one by one in here, this conversation. Because that, in that way, we are going to reduce time and we are going to focus in some activities on the book from there. Okay, so this conversation is between Jessica and Roxana, okay? And it says Roxana and Jessica. Okay, it says Jessica. Hi, Roxana. Listen up. Hi, Roxana. Welcome to Rex. Welcome to Rex. My name is Jessica. My name is Jessica. I'm the industrial safety engineer. I'm the industrial safety engineer. And it says, Roxana, thanks, Jessica. Thanks, Jessica. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you. And it says, Jessica, my department is responsible for keeping the safety of the plant. Listen again. My department is responsible for keeping the safety of the plant. And it says, Roxana, I see. I see. Listen up. I'll be part of the maintenance. Be part of the maintenance department. Will I be responsible to you? Will I be responsible to you? It says, Jessica, great. Great. Our departments work together. Our departments work together. But the maintenance chief is in charge of directing your department. Okay. Jewel, listen to this one. Jewel, be responsible to him. To him. Okay, and it says Roxana. Thank you, Jessica. Thank you, Jessica. May I call you if I need help? May I call you if I need help? And it says, Jessica, sure. Sure. Very good. From here, people, do you have any questions related to this vocabulary from the conversation? ¿Tenemos alguna duda, alguna pregunta con relación al vocabulario de esta conversación? El chucho. Ok, ajá.
En la segunda intervención donde, de Roxana, donde dice I see, luego dice
I'll be part.
I'll be part.
Ajá. I'll es una contraction between I and will. I will. Esa es una contracción de futuro, de I y el verbo will. Y luego tenemos be. Entonces ahí dice, I'll be part of the maintenance department. Seré parte. Seré. I will be. I'll be part of the maintenance department. Seré parte del departamento de mantenimiento. Okay. Yeah. Esa es una contraction. Remember the I will.
Y en la segunda parte de esa misma intervención de Roxana, es al revés. Dice, will I. La que acaba de mencionarle este Hilmar.
Will I.
Will I.
Ah, ¿y por qué es que está al revés?
Porque es pregunta.
Exactly. Porque primero se coloca el auxiliar y después el subject. Y como ahí will es un auxiliar, por eso se coloca de principio. ¿Ok?
Very good. Thank you, teacher.
Very good. Will I be, seré? Ok. Good. Any other word? Any other vocabulary? Safety, seguridad. Safety.
Thank you, teacher.
Okay. Any other word, people? Everything is okay now.
Teacher.
The chief.
Chief. Chief is like boss. Ese es como el jefe de ese departamento. Okay. Chief se le dice a un jefe de departamento.
Ok, thank you.
Ajá, como el departamento de mantenimiento, that's a maintenance chief. Departamento de tecnología, that's a IT chief. Yeah, chief is another way to say boss. Very good. Any other word, Nubia? I think you were about to say something.
It's the same question.
Chief? ¿Era la misma?
Uh-huh.
Ah, ok, yes. Yeah, means jefe. Very good. Okay, what are we gonna do now? Listen, ahora lo vamos a practicar. I need you to put this into context. And how are we going to do? We're gonna do it like right now in here. And for that, I want Nubia and Eric to start doing it. So in this case, Nubia, take the role of Jessica and Eric, take the role of Roxana. Let's go for it.
Okay.
Let's do it.
Hi, Roxana. Welcome to REC. My name is Jessica. I am the industrial safety engineer.
Thanks, Jessica. Nice to meet you.
My department is responsible for keeping the safety of the plant.
I see. I'll be part of my maintenance department. Will I be responsible to you?
Great. Our department works together. But the maintenance chief is in charge of directing your department. You'll be responsible to him.
Thank you, Jessica. May I call you if I need help?
Sure.
Okay, very good. Thank you, Nubia, and thank you, Eric. You did it excellent. Now, Fatima and Ana Maria, I need your help. Fatima, you're going to be Jessica, and Ana Maria is going to be Roxana.
Okay. Hi, Roxana. Welcome to REX. My name is Jessica. I am the industrial safety engineer.
Thanks, Jessica. Nice to meet you.
My department mm-hmm. is responsible for keeping the safety of the plant.
Okay, okay. Stay there. Stay there. Safety. Repeat it.
Safety.
Okay. Safety. Okay, good. Continue, okay. Maria.
IC will be part of the maintenance department. Will I be responsible to you?
Okay, okay. Great. Stay there. In that case, Ana Maria, vuelve mm-hmm. a leer la pregunta, por favor. Can you repeat the question?
I see.
No, the question.
Will I be responsible?
Responsible?
To you.
Okay, sí, pero en este caso quiero que lo lea como que en verdad está leyendo una pregunta, porque ahí me lo está leyendo como una oración. ¿Cómo hacerlo? La intonation, yeah, the intonation at the end. Listen up. Will I be responsible to you?
Will I be responsible to you?
Ah, okay. Good.
Great. Our departments work together, but the maintenance chief is in charge of directing your department. You'll be responsible to him.
Thank you, Jessica. May I call you if I need help?
Sure.
Ah, okay, very good. Thank you, Fatima. Thank you, Ana Marisha. Let's continue. Rosa del Carmen and Hilmore, help me out. Rosa, take the action of Jessica and Hilmore, the other one. Roxana.
Okay. Hi, Roxana. Welcome to Rex. My name is Jessica. I am the industrial safety and engineer.
Engineer, very good.
Thanks, Jessica. Nice to meet you.
My department is responsible keeping the safety of the plant.
Okay. Repeat it again, Rosa.
My department is responsible keeping
for the keeping, safety for keeping,
for keeping the safety of the plant.
Very good.
I see. All before ours, the maintenance department, will I be responsible to you?
To you? Mm-hmm.
Great, our departments work together, but the
maintenance
chief is in charge of directions.
Directing
your department. You'll be responsible to him.
Thank you, Jessica. May I call you I need help?
Repeat it, Hilmar.
Thank you, Jessica. May I call you I
if
I need help?
Very good.
Sure.
Ok, no, pues con esa expresión así, no le llamo. It's like, sure. ¿Qué más, Rosa? Had to be more emotional. Ok, but that's good. Thank you, Rosa, and thank you, Hilmar. Ok, Sara and Joanny, help me out, please. So Sarah is going to take the action of Jessica, and Roxana, it's going to be Joanny. I mean, Joanny is going to be a...
Okay.
You know what I'm talking about.
Hi, Roxana. Welcome to Reds. My name is Jessica. I am the Industrial Society Engineer.
I'm the Industrial Safety Engineer. Very good.
Thanks, Jessica. Nice to meet you.
My department is responsible for keeping the safety of the plant.
Okay, my department.
My department is responsible for keeping
the safety
of the plant.
Very good.
I see. All the part of the maintenance department.
Joanny, I'm sorry. It's department.
Department.
Yes, very good.
The department will be responsible to you.
To you?
Great. Or department? Great. Or department work together, but the maintenance sheet is charged of the department.
Okay, directing
chairs of directing your department. You'll be responsible to him?
Yeah, you'll be responsible to him. Very good.
Thank you, Jessica. May I call you if I need help?
Sure.
Sure. Okay. Thank you, Sarah, and thank you, Joanny. You did it excellent. Now, Carla, I want you to work with Ever. So, Carla, take the action of Jessica, and Ever is going to be Roxana.
Okay. Hi, Roxana. Welcome to REC. My name is Jessica. I'm the industrial safety engineer.
Thanks, Jessica. Nice to meet you.
My department is responsible for keeping the safety of the plant.
I see. I'll be part of the maintenance department. Will I be responsible to you?
Great. Our department work together, but the maintenance chief is the chance of directing your department. You'll be responsible to him.
Okay, remember, directing.
Directing, okay.
Very good.
Thank you, Jessica. May I call you if I need help?
Sure.
Okay, very good. Thank you, Carla, and thank you, Ever. You did it excellent. Now, Anna, I want you to work with Natalie Vanessa.
Okay, teacher.
Okay, in this case, Natalie be Jessica and Anna be Roxana.
Okay, Jessica. Hi, Roxana. Welcome to REX. My name is Jessica. I am the industrial safety engineer.
Thanks, Jessica. Nice to meet you.
My department is responsible for keeping the safety of the plant.
I see. I be part of the
maintaining
department. Will I be responsible to you?
Great. Our department work together, but the maintenance chief is in charge of directing your department. You will be responsible to him.
Thank you, Jessica. May I call you if I need help?
Sure.
Okay, sure. Yeah. Like that. Okay, thank you, Natalie, and thank you, Anna. You did it excellent. Now, Let's see, William, I want you to help me out with Stephanie Rutia. William, be Jessica, and Stephanie, be Roxana.
Okay.
William, are you there?
Yes.
Ah, okay. Okay, take the role of Jessica. Yeah.
Now.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Hi, Roxana. Welcome to Rex. My name is Jessica. I am the industrial safety engineer.
Thanks, Jessica. Nice to meet you.
My department is responsible for keeping the safety of the plant.
Very good.
I see. Part of the maintaining department, will I be responsible to you?
Great. Our departments work together, but the maintenance chief is in charge of directing your department. You will be responsible to him.
Okay, directing.
Thank you, Jessica. May I call you if I need help?
Sure.
Okay, perfect. Thank you, Stephanie. Thank you, William. You did it excellent. Mm. Now, I want Romeo to help me out with Jonathan. Romeo is going to be Jessica, and Roxana is going to take the role by Jonathan.
Okay. Hi, Roxana. Welcome to Rex. My name is Jessica. I'm the industrial certified engineer.
Safety engineer.
Safety engineer.
Excellent.
Thanks. Thanks, Jessica. Nice to meet you. I see. No. My department is responsible.
Responsible?
Pardon?
Responsible?
Responsible for keeping the safety of the plant.
Yeah.
I see. I'll be part of my maintenance department. Will I be responsible to you? Great. Our department work together. Come on.
Together. Yes.
But the maintenance chief in the chair.
Is in
charge.
Is in church.
Okay. Is in charge of directing. Okay. Directing your department. You'll be responsible to him. Thank you, Jessica. My God, I need help.
Sure. Okay. Good. Thank you, Romeo. And thank you, Jonathan. You did it excellent. So now, let me see who has not participated. Se me movieron las cuadrículas. Rosa del Carmen. And just you, Rosa. Okay, Rosa. Practice with me. Who you want to be, Jessica or Roxana?
Teacher, yo ya estuvo. Ya pasé con Gilmer, creo que fue.
Really? You were the last one.
Yes.
Se me movió.
Con Gilmar, si no estoy mal.
Se me fue una. Never remember. Con razón se me movieron las cuadrículas. Okay, good. Anyways, let's continue with this. Okay, now that we have been practicing this, let's focus on the manual. Now, open up your manuals. Voy a dejar de compartir pantalla y nos vamos para el manual, okay? Give me a second. Oh my God.
Teacher, puede enviar el manual al grupo porque no lo tengo.
Ah, ok, ahorita lo voy a reenviar. Otra vez.
Ay, no lo quiere mandar, no lo manda.
Aquí está, hombre. Tranquila. ¿Qué le pasa? Está agresiva.
Pues sí, como dice, otra vez.
Yes, es que lo tenía, así que solo lo reenvío.
Es que ahora
se unió, ¿verdad?
Que me metí al grupo y todo.
Ah, con razón. Sí vi a alguien que se había unido. That's cool. Turn on your camera. I want to see you.
Ah, porque ahorita estoy en el WhatsApp.
Ah, open it up. Ah, es que lo tienen desde su celular, ¿cierto?
Ajá.
Okay, good. What are you gonna do in there? So I want you to go straight to page 13. In page 13, it's basically what we were discussing right now in the conversation. Give me a second. What is it? Ah, this is the one. Okay, it's in here. This is part of what we had. Okay, this was the conversation that we were practicing. Now, listen, what are we gonna do in here? ¿Qué vamos a hacer acá? Easy. We are going to answer these questions. Ahora que estuvimos practicando la conversación, ahora vamos a hacer una pequeña, okay, actividad. Let me see, dice acá. Discuss the answers to the questions below. Compare your answer with another pair. It says, who is responsible for keeping the safety of the personnel in the plant? En este caso acá, ¿de dónde vamos a sacar esa información? Where from? From the conversation, de la conversación. Who is the responsible? Jessica or Roxana?
Jessica.
Are you sure?
Jessica, puse yo.
Ah, okay. Write it down there. Si no tenemos el manual impreso, ya saben, simplemente en nuestro cuaderno ahí copiamos la respuesta, okay? The answer to that. Okay? Good. Bien, entonces, háganme las demás, por favor. Let's do the other ones. I will give you 1 minute for each one. So you're gonna have 3 minutes to do it. Just 3 minutes. So then we're gonna check. Let me know when you finish. En la número 3 dice, who is Roxana responsible to? Quiero una oración completa como respuesta. ¿Cómo así? Ah, Roxana is responsible to, y luego colocamos, ok, ¿cuál es su función? O, ¿de quién es? Ok, ¿a quién le debe de rendir cuentas? As I told you, let me know when you finish. That's the man, you know. Hmm. La número 4 la vamos a sacar del mapa que está ahí, ¿ok? Del organizatorio. Pero dice floor manager, safety engineer, maintenance chief, supervisor, maintenance personnel, bla, bla, bla. Let me know when you finish. Okay, how do you go? ¿Por cuál vamos? ¿Terminando la última?
Buscando la postura del diálogo y no lo he hecho.
Ah, okay. This is... Vaya, ahorita para que le tomen la pintura. Ahí está. Look. That's the dialogue. Okay, perfect. Okay, let's start, people, because we need to do the next page. Let me see who can help me out with this, with the ring. Novia, can you please read question number 2?
Okay. Who is in charge of the directing the maintenance personnel?
Who is in charge of directing the maintenance personnel? Can somebody give me the answer? Is it Roxana? Is it Jessica?
Jessica?
Jessica? Does everybody have Jessica?
Yes, teacher.
Number 2. Yes, and in this case, it's Jessica. Very good. Number 3, let me see, Roxana was about to say, but Roxana is not here. Fatima, help me out with number 3. No, read, Roxana, read. Fatima, you got the microphone off. Solo la veo hablar.
No. Who? No, okay. Who is Roxana responsible to?
Okay, who is Roxana responsible to?
Is responsible to maintenance chief? I know,
she is responsible. Roxana is responsible to?
Maintenance chief.
Yeah. To the maintenance chief. Very good.
Chief.
Does everybody has that one? Everybody? Okay, perfect. Let's see. Eric, read number 4.
Look at the organizational chart above. Who are the safety engineer and the maintenance chief responsible to?
Maintenance chief and safety engineer. What are they responsible to?
Maintenance is responsible to the floor manager.
Both of them. Exactly. En ese caso son los dos, Eric.
Ah, okay. Okay.
Acá vamos a poner, ah, listen, listen. The safety engineer and the maintenance chief, listen, listen, are responsible to, are responsible to the floor manager. Esa sería la respuesta ahí, ¿ok?
Ok, teacher, thank you.
The answer. The safety engineer and the maintenance chief are responsible to the floor manager. To the floor manager. Okay. Very good. So now that we have done that, let's move on to the next page. What are we going to find out in here? Look, this is part of what we were discussing, okay, in the presentation. Acá es parte de lo que estuvimos discutiendo en la presentación. Dice, use the a verb plus, en este caso sería ing, after prepositions like for or of, que son las dos preposiciones que estuvimos trabajando. In expressions as be responsible for, be in charge of, be accountable for, committed to, or dedicated to. Okay? Y acá nos dice, to say who you report to, use be responsible to and be accountable to. Aquí es nosotros a quién nos reportamos. Okay? ¿Hacia quién? Remember that. Cuando usamos to es hacia una persona, ¿ok? O empresa en este caso. Luego, to talk about your responsibilities, use. Ah, pero hablar de nuestras responsabilidades o actividades que hacemos, usamos be responsible for. Ya no sería to, tiene que ser for. Remember that. Be in charge of. Ah, ser responsable de o estar a cargo de. Be in charge of, be accountable for. So those ones are for activities that we do. Okay. Bien. ¿Alguna pregunta con esto? Any question with this? With this chart? ¿Algo que no esté del todo claro? You can ask people. Recordemos, cuando usamos to, es hacia quién nosotros vamos a reportar algo, ¿ok? Y for es más que todo usado para actividades que nosotros hacemos, ¿ok? Lo que nos toca como trabajadores, la responsabilidad, ¿ok? Bien, si no tenemos preguntas, dice acá, listen. Complete the questions below with the appropriate verb form. Ah, completar las siguientes preguntas con la forma apropiada del verbo. Then read the information in Rex organizational chart to answer the questions. Check answer with the partner. Ah, luego leer la information en Rex organizational chart y luego pues ver el cartel organizativo, ok, de Rex, que es la compañía, para responder las preguntas. Ok, tenemos el chart in here. En la top o head tenemos general manager o el director general, ok, el que dirige la compañía. Luego de él tenemos auditor. In the auditor, we got quality control inspector, floor manager, financial department, computer department, sales department. In floor manager, we have safety engineer, ok. It's the safety engineer, ok, it goes to the supervisor. It has a supervisor, it has a machine operators, assemblers, and truck drivers. Then, the floor manager has a maintenance chief, and has a maintenance personnel. Ok, ahora bien, ¿qué vamos a hacer en las oraciones que tenemos acá? Listen, in these examples. Ah, pretty easy. Vamos a hacer la número uno. What does the number one says? Listen. Who is responsible for, y acá tenemos un verbo en paréntesis. ¿Cómo tiene que ir el verbo acá? Can somebody tell me how the verb must go?
Supervising.
Exactly, right? Supervising. Like this. Who is responsible for supervising the machine operators? Who is the responsible? Acá en la segunda línea de puntitos vamos a escribir la respuesta acá. In here.
The supervisor.
Exactly. It's in here. Look. Supervisor. Ah. You see? And we got the answer there. There you go. Good. Now, what are we going to do here? Ahora, quiero que tomando como ejemplo esa que acabamos de hacer, me hagan las demás. Ok. Remember que tenemos que tomar en cuenta el chart que tenemos ahí, el recuadro. Ok. To do it. Give me a second. What happened to this? Oh. There you go. No sé si se puede ver el chart. Yeah. Yes. You can watch most of it. Ahí está el recuadro. Ahí está el mapa. The map. So you can do it. Give me a second. What happened? There you go. Okay, let's do the other ones and let me know when you finish. Or let's try to do it together. Example. Sarah. Sarah is going to help me out. Sarah, can you please read question number two?
Chickens. Chickens.
Yeah, pero léame la pregunta.
Oh, who is charged of the chickens?
Okay.
Who is charged of the chicken?
Checking. Uh-huh. The quality.
The quality of the products.
Ah, okay. The answer?
Ahí estaba todavía.
Ah, mire, ok. Si estamos hablando de quality, de calidad. Ok, ¿quién es el encargado de esto?
El inspector, control de...
Exactly, right? De quality.
Control inspector.
Yes, that's the first thing. That is the person. Very good, Sarah. Thank you. Okay, let's see. I'm gonna choose another person to help me out. William, can you please be so kind and read number three?
Okay, who is responsible for repair the problem on the machines?
For the machines. Uh-huh. So in that case, it will be?
Is maintenance.
Maintaining?
Maintaining chief.
This one?
Yes, maintain it, cheese.
Okay, let me see. Who is responsible for repairing the problems of the machines? Ah, where do we got the machines? Exactly. Maintenance chip. Let me see. Yeah, the machines, the maintaining personnel, maintaining chip. Okay, good. Thank you.
Okay.
Next, for the next, I want Hilmar to help me out. Hilmar, are you there? Okay. I think he's there, but he's busy.
Hello.
Okay. Sammy. Okay, but read it, read it.
Who is accountable for selling the product?
Uh-huh. Who is the response? Who is accountable for selling the products?
Sales department.
Very good. Sales department. Okay. Thank you. Jonathan, help me out with number five.
Who is in charge of fixing the assemblers?
Okay. Who is in charge of assisting the assemblers? Uh-huh.
Assemblers.
Aha, who is in charge, Jonathan?
Sales department. No, es el anterior.
No, porque aquí tenemos, vamos a ver, the assemblers. Assemblers. Assemblers lo tenemos acá, mire. In here, in this part.
Eso le dije y no me contestó.
Nah, really? I didn't listen then. Okay, so tenemos machine operators or supervisor. ¿Cuál de los dos sería?
Yo pensé que era assembler, ¿verdad?
No, porque la pregunta dice de assembler. ¿Quién está encargado de asistir, okay, a los ensambladores?
Machine operators.
Does everybody has that? Machine operators? Which one do you have, people?
The supervisor.
The supervisor.
Ah, yeah.
El supervisor.
Porque es quien está. One, okay, one top ahead. Exactly. In that case, it will be the supervisor. There you go. Okay, the supervisor. Okay, so thank you, Jonathan. Next, in this case, let me see who got the Eric, help me out, Eric.
La única que no había contestado.
Sorry, man. Okay, okay, do it.
Okay, este, vamos a ver.
Read, read.
Who is accountable for manage the whole operation?
Managing?
Eso es lo que dice. Luego sustituimos manage por managing.
Ajá.
The whole operation. Eso es lo que quería saber. Eso es lo que iba a poner, que no sé qué significa.
Ah, whole operate, whole significa todo, toda. En the whole operation, toda la operación.
Ok. General manager.
Very good. Yeah, that's the general manager. The general manager. That's the one in charge of the whole operation. Es el encargado de toda la operación. Yeah. There you go. Now, you got it there? Okay, perfect. So people, if you got them, we're gonna stay up here. I don't know if you have any questions related to this. No sé si tienen alguna pregunta con relación al tema, a la estructura que hemos estado viendo. Any questions related to this? Antes que nos vayamos, recuerden que nos vamos a volver a ver hasta el próximo lunes. Yeah. After vacations, yeah. Miren, Rosa está celebrando. Rosa. Yeah, we're celebrating. Any question with this? ¿Alguna pregunta? No. Okay. Good. All right, people. Let me stop sharing. Then I'm gonna pass the attendance list, and then we are going to end up this video conference. Give me a second. What are we going to do right now is just to pass the attendance list. What is it? Okay, give me a second. Ana Claribel. Hey, where is Ana? Did she leave? Oh my God. Ana Maria.
Present.
Ah, okay. Good. Diana Gabriela.
Present.
Okay, perfect. Eric Guillermo.
Present, teacher.
Nice. Ever de Jesus.
Present.
All right, great. Fatima Alejandra.
Present.
Okay, Floridalia didn't show up, right? Hilmar Cruz.
Present.
Okay, Jonathan Alexander. Present. Ah, yeah. Okay, thank you, Jonathan. Natalie Vanessa.
Present.
Okay, Nuria Zulema.
Present.
Thanks. Romeo Alexis.
Present.
Okay. Let's see. Mega, what happened? Okay, Rosa del Carmen.
Present.
Okay, Rosana no here. Salvador Alfonso. Ah, yeah, Salvador, you're right. Sara Carolina.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Stephanie Lisette.
Present.
Yeah, okay, thank you, miss. William Alberto.
Present.
Okay, thank you, mister. Joanny Noemi. Hey, Joanny has problems with the internet. Ah, okay, Joanny.
Present.
Okay, todavía continúa con los problemitas. Okay, Stephanie Janet. Okay, good. Now, people, if you don't have any question, I am going to stay up today with, let me see. Hey, Anna, did you leave, Anna? Oh my God. Okay. Give me a second, because I have a schedule to work with Anna today. But since Anna is not here, I was supposed to be working with the next person that continues with her. But the next person is not here. Give me a second. I'm going to play stop. Because yesterday I was working with Ana Maria. Now I was supposed to be working with, with Anna. But Anna is not here. So Eric. Sorry, man, you're gonna be the next. Yeah, because Diana is not here already. Okay, so Eric, stay with me. And for the rest, felices vacaciones, people. Espero las disfruten. You know, para los que van a tener vacaciones. Y nos vemos el siguiente lunes. Ajá.
¿Va a dejar tarea o algo?
Yes.
Tenía que ser. Mejor quédese los 10 minutos, Nubia.
Listen. Hagan la tarea número 2. Ok, tienen toda la semana para hacerlo. Ok. Y igual, en la zona de discusión, ahí les va a quedar la tarea. Ok. Recuerden que ahí simplemente cuando entren a la zona de discusión les va a aparecer una, o sea, el layout en blanco. Denle clic donde dice todos los temas y ahí les van a aparecer. Ok. Si no han hecho la discussion one, háganla, por favor. Do it. Van a tener toda una semana para hacerlo. Sí. Ok, perfecto.
Pero no necesitamos hacerlo ahora. Lo vamos a hacer la siguiente
semana. No necesariamente. Ah, pero
el viernes la hace, Nubia.
No me lo vaya a hacer el viernes de la otra semana.
El viernes la hace, Nubia.
Okay. No, not that way. Because you're going to have vacations, so let's do it, ok? So, bye-bye, people. See you.
Bye.
See you after vacation. Bye bye.
Happy vacation.
Okay.
Happy vacation. Bye.
Bye. See you.
Bye, teacher.
Okay. Bye, Stephanie. No ande de enojada.
Pórtese bien.
Ah, usted también, pórtese bien. Okay, bye bye. Okay, Eric.
So, okay, teacher.
Vamos a tener, son las 10:09. Bueno, 10:10. We're gonna have 10 minutes of feedback. Igual, okay. Esos 10 minutos van a ser para hablar sobre la clase de ayer y la clase de este día, para aclarar cualquier punto que usted pueda tener que todavía no haya captado o no haya entendido de la mejor manera como usted quisiera. So, estos 10 minutos son para ello.
Sí, de hecho, fíjese que yo hubiera preferido quedarme más adelante, ¿verdad? Porque con esto sí no he sentido mayor complicación, ¿verdad? Los he entendido. Uh-huh. Por eso hubiera querido más adelante, ¿verdad? Pero en vista de, no he tenido mayor complicación con los infinitives y con lo que hemos visto el día de hoy, tampoco no siento mayor complicación, ¿verdad? Más que todo, realmente no, es bastante. Bastante, cool. Bastante bien. O sea, no me he sentido complicado. He sentido más complicado en otras clases, ¿verdad? Pero ahorita sí no. Más que todo lo del vocabulario, ¿verdad? Que dudé un poco ahí con accountable, lo estaba relacionando con lo que es contable y cabal, la última que Wall creo que era.
Ajá, sí, que en este caso sí, ya ahí es. Ajá,
the Wall Operation.
Ajá, the whole, así. Esa whole. Es una frase igual, que significa todo. O toda.
Uh-huh. Whole.
Yeah. Por ejemplo, si decimos the whole world, todo el mundo.
De todo el mundo.
Like the whole world, todo el mundo. Sí, entonces la palabra whole, así, significa todo.
Okay.
Todo. Whole.
Esa palabra para mí sí es nueva, porque yo solo decía all es todo, decir.
Ah.
Pero whole para mí fue nuevo ahora.
Ya, yeah, es una nueva palabra. Good. Uh-huh. Ajá, y tenemos otra palabra que es igual a esta, miren. Whole.
Whole.
Se pronuncian lo mismo, whole, uh-huh. Whole. Pero whole, esta es, whole. Significa todo o toda, ¿ok? Y uh-huh. Esto es whole de hoyo.
Ah, de hoyo.
Eso significa hoyo.
Hoyo. Oh. Y se pronuncian igual.
Se pronuncian igual, ya que la W no tiene sonido en esta palabra.
Sí.
Se pronuncian igual. Ahí el contexto es que le va a guiar a usted cuándo es que estamos utilizando esta y cuándo es esta.
Ah, ok.
Ya, el contexto es el que nos va a ayudar en this case. Yes.
Permítame, lo apunto también porque eso sí es nuevo.
Recuerde que también tenemos como un sinónimo, también es everything.
Everything. Ah,
everything también es parte de ese sinónimo, que significa todo.
Sí, exacto. De everything.
Yeah.
Oye, ok. Ah, va. Sí, es cierto, everything. Ah, pero sí, yo lo relacionaba con all. Y por eso whole.
Ah, okay.
Entire es todo también.
Yes. También significa todo.
Pero okay. Eso, entire está más, ¿cómo le dijera? Más aplicado a partes. Ajá, the entire world.
All the world, look at this. And then we got another one let's see.
Everything.
Okay, everything, ya sí, ya no se puede utilizar tal y como estábamos ahí, right? Ok, everything, ya es más que todo para mencionar, how can I say this? Un todo, como everything, todo en el mundo, like todo en el mundo. The world es uno solo, ok? So, yo puedo decir the entire world, ok, el mundo entero, the whole world, todo el mundo, all the world, ok? Pero no decimos everything the world, porque es incorrecto. So, tiene que ser everything in the world, todo en el mundo, o sea, todo lo que world. Existe, todo lo que existe dentro, ok, of the world.
Dentro del mundo.
Exactly.
Pero...
Okay.
Y yo lo estaba relacionando como cada cosa en el mundo.
No. También, o sea, lo podemos bajar hacia categorías. No. También lo podemos bajar a categorías. Por ejemplo, podemos decir, the entire day, el día entero.
El día entero.
The whole day, o all day. You see? Pero ¿por qué lo estamos haciendo así? Porque como estamos mencionando un día, como todo. ¿Ok? Como todo. Y acá lo mismo, miren. Everything in the day. Todo en el día. Ya, everything incluye todas las actividades que se hicieron en el día. The whole day, todo el día. Ahí no estamos mencionando actividades que se hicieron en el día, no, sino que abarcando todo el día en sí. ¿Got it?
Ok, solo, permítame, le hago una captura a esto, que lo quiero guardar.
Ok.
Ok, thank you. Pues sí, ya lo capturé.
Perfecto. Ahora sí.
Excelente, excelente.
You see, ya aprendimos algo nuevo. That's cool. Esa es la idea de que cada vez vayamos aprendiendo, cada día vamos aprendiendo algo nuevo. That's cool.
Exacto, sí, es dicha.
That's really cool.
No, y la verdad que es algo que no me imaginé que de una palabrita todo lo que se desglosó.
Sí, entonces
sí.
Generalmente así es como uno debe de aprender el vocabulario. Eso es como a modo de consejo, de que siempre que aprendamos una palabra, tratemos de investigar si esa palabra tiene sinónimos para saber cuándo utilizarlos. Y así, de una palabra, podemos sacar hasta tres palabras extras como un solo vocabulario. Por ejemplo, de la palabra whole, ya sacamos la palabra everything, la palabra entire.
Entire. Everything.
And everything. Sí, that's the way. Entonces, ¿qué es lo único que hay que aprenderse en este tipo de situaciones? Los usos, cuándo utilizar cada una de ellas o cómo utilizarla en este caso. Recordar que everything no se parece a las demás, ¿ok? Porque everything incluye todo tipo de actividad que nosotros podemos hacer. Las demás indican un todo en sí. ¿Ok?
Ok. Ok.
Very good.
No, ok.
Any other question? ¿Alguna pregunta adicional?
No, realmente no.
Quiero
ver con lo que tengo mis apuntes aquí, con mis apuntes, algo. No me queda bien claro que responsible for son actividades, responsible to es ante alguien, accountable for es lo mismo que responsible for. Y lo otro era solamente teacher.
That's very cool. Okay, I'm glad to hear that. En la plataforma igual ya se tiene acceso, ¿cierto?
Ya hice la primera tarea, la del día de ayer. La discusión sí no la hice, sinceramente. Ha sido un día bien movido para mí ahora. Y va a ser, ya le dije, ¿verdad? Que va a ser todos estos días. Entonces, para serles sincero, en las vacaciones lo voy a trabajar.
You're not gonna have vacations then. Pero va a tener algún día en específico, like not to go.
Fíjense que en teoría salgo el miércoles a mediodía y me presento lunes. Pero como están las tiendas, las que le mencioné, las tiendas Simi, ellas están todo el tiempo, ellos no cierran, ¿verdad? Entonces, cualquier problema que ellos tengan, tengo que conectarme y ayudarles. Entonces, y hoy me han estado asignando también otras actividades y ya estoy pendiente de algunas sucursales también, de ferreterías. Oh, entonces, sí, mañana temprano, 7:30, estoy en una ferretería viendo un problema que no pueden entrar a la red. Luego tengo que estar a las 8:15, 8:30 en la oficina. Salgo a las 12. Ah, una locura.
Oh, my God. Yes, a full day. Okay. So, suerte con ello, Eric, okay?
Thank you, teacher.
Best of luck. Entonces, bueno. No me resta más que decirle felices vacaciones, aunque no las tenga.
Igualmente, teacher.
Yes, same here. Sí. Okay. Yeah.
Entonces,
nos vemos hasta el próximo lunes, ¿ok?
Excelente, teacher. All gracias right, ahí teacher. Por todo hoy.
Okay, ya sabe. Okay. Have a good night.
Good night, teacher.
Bye bye.
Bye.